days ago. I received a call from someone asking for a website for his chain of hotels in just 1 week. With listing, filtering, booking, and all other capabilities. He's globally known as the Wolf of Wall Street. Time's ticking. And there is not much time left before I kick this project's ass.
Hello, my friends. This is the second episode of my journey to create a hotel website for the Wolf of Wall Street in a week. It's so hot. Wait. In the first episode, we defined the custom room post type, built a listing for its single page, and a nice template for it. In this episode, we will create an archive listing for our room post type, where people will be able to search and filter different rooms and click on the one they're interested in. So let's get this thing done and get one step closer to what Wolf of Wall Street wanted.
As you'll recall, we created a custom post type for our room called Rooms and then created a listing for it. A listing is an embodiment of the meta fields in a custom post type with a particular design. In the first part, we built the custom post for our rooms and the listing and beautiful design for the single page. The only thing is that the single page is not discoverable by visitors if it's not inside a post feed. Someone should play with filters in your listing page and find the item they want. Click on it and enter the single page for that item. Before proceeding with the tutorial, don't forget to check if the following plugins are activated and have the minimum versions below. As you noticed, in addition to what we used in the first part, we need the JetSmart Filters plugin in this part to create the filters we require for our archive listing. In this tutorial, we'll cover the following: creating a listing template for our custom post type, creating filters for our listing, creating a general listing template. So first things first, just like the listing we built for the single page of our custom post type, we need to create a listing for the listing archive. In the WordPress dashboard, go to Jet Engine, Listings, Add New. In the upcoming dialog, set listing source to posts, post type to rooms, and give it a name such as Rooms Archive and proceed. You'll be taken to the Elementor environment to create a design template for the new listing. Add a box section with 374 pixels width and add 15 pixels bottom padding. Right-click on the column. From Styles, set the background color as white. And from Advanced tab, set the bottom padding for the column as 25 pixels. Add an image element inside the section. Set the image source as Dynamic Custom Image and give it a custom size of 374 pixels width and 220 pixels height. Set a dynamic image source and choose Field as Post Thumbnail. Add a dynamic field setting the source to post and the object field to title. Centralize it and format it as you like. I'll go with 200 pixels, mooly, bold, and this color. Give it a 15 top, 15 bottom padding from the Advanced tab. Add a dynamic field, set the source to metadata and the meta field to beds. Centralize it and format it as you like. I'll go with 16 pixels, mooly, and this color. Add a dynamic field, set the source to metadata, and the meta field to price. In order to automatically add the dollar sign before the price, in the dynamic field settings, add dollar sign, percentage sign, S to the field format. You can style it as you want. I'll put 20 pixels, mooly, bold, and this color. Add a 20 pixels bottom padding to the price. Add a dynamic link element, set the source as permalink, label it as book now, and centralize it. Format it as 14 pixels, mouli, white, and a 600 weight. In normal state, set a light red colored background for it, with white as text color. In hover state, reverse color by giving the same light red as text color and white to background color. You should define a solid 1 pixel border colored light red, 3 pixels border radius in all corners, and 7 top, 15 right, 7 bottom, and 15 left paddings. In the WordPress dashboard, go to Templates, Save Templates, Add New. Select Archive as template type and give it a name. Add a listing grid element to your page. Set the Rooms Archive as listing source and activate Uses Archive Template option. In the WordPress dashboard, go to JupyterX, Customize, Post Types, Rooms, Rooms Archive, and select the page you just saved and then publish the changes. Okay, what's next? We just designed how a room custom post type will appear in the listing. Now we need to put this inside a general template for the listing. But before that, let's create the filters we need for the listing sidebar. Let's say we need a price range filter and some checkbox filters for our room facilities. With JetSmart Filters V1.5 installed, in the WordPress dashboard, go to Smart Filters, Add New. We'll give our filter a label, an active filter label. Set the filter type as range. Set value prefix as dollar sign. Set the minimum and maximum value as you wish. Set a step number. This is the amount added to the selected range every time the visitor moves the indicator one step. For example, if set to 5, every time you move the indicator to the right or left, an amount 5 will be added or deducted to the range. And finally, give the filter a query variable. This query variable will help us connect the filter to its results in the other hand of the listing page. Using the same process, we should create checkbox filters for our room facilities. The only part that will be different is set the filter type as checkbox list and data source as manual input. Activate the isCheckboxMetaField option to filter data from checkboxMetafields type created with JetEngine plugin. In the options list box, add checkbox options for the filter. Each option should have a value and label. Just as an important side note, the value for a checkbox option should match with the checkbox value of the custom meta field it relates to. The query variable value should match with the name or ID of the custom meta field it relates to. With the filters created and the template designed for the individual listing, we can design a general template for the listing on our website where users can use the filters in the sidebar to define the room criteria they want and see the results on the other side. In the WordPress dashboard, go to Pages, Add New. From lower left corner, click on Elementor Settings icon and select Elementor Full Width as Page Layout. Give the main section 55 top, 0 right, 90 bottom, and 0 left pixels paddings from the Advanced tab. We need a 30% and 70% column pair. The 30% column in the right will contain the filters and the 70% column on the left will carry the filter results. Apply 0 pixel widget space to the left column. From the Style tab, add a white background color to the column. From the Border section, add a 6 pixels radius to all corners of the column. From the Advanced tab, add margins, 5 top, 0 right, 580 bottom, and 25 left pixels, and paddings, 30 top, 32 right, 30 bottom, and 32 left. For the right column, from the Advanced tab, add 25 pixels left paddings to it. Add a JX heading element to the left column and edit it to filter listing. Format the heading as you like. We'll input mouli, bold, 24 pixels with cerulean blue color. From the Advanced tab, give it a 35 pixels bottom padding to it. Add another heading element and edit it for the price and format as you like. We'll go with mouli, 20 pixels, bold, with this dark blue color. Give the second heading a 25 pixels bottom padding. Add a range filter element to the left column. Select price range as filter and set jet engine for this filter 4. Apply on should be set on click on apply button. Query ID should be set to rooms. On the styling tab, set the color to this blue and border radius to 2 in all corners. Set the background color to range point. We'll go with this color and the border radius of 3 pixels to all corners. In range subtab, set this color. In the value section, format the text for value. We'll go ahead and put Muli, 16 pixels, and this dark blue with the top padding of 25 pixels. From the advanced tab, give the range filter a 20 pixels bottom padding. What's left in this section of filters is a filter results button. Drag an apply button element below the price indicator. Set its query ID as rooms and style it as you like. In the style tab, for the normal state button, we'll go with Muli, 14 pixels, weight 600, with white as the color and the cerulean blue as the background color. A solid border of 1 pixel with cerulean blue, a border radius of 3 pixels and a padding of 11 top, 25 right, 11 bottom, and 25 pixels left. For its hover state, we'll swap the color and background colors. Finally, in the advanced tab, give the button a 30 pixels bottom padding. But before that, in order to make the filter stand out, let's change the main section's color. Drag the checkbox filters element below the filter button. Select the filters as needed. This filter 4 should be set as jet engine. Apply type is Ajax. Apply on is click on apply button. Query ID should be set to rooms. In the style tab, set 10 for both space between and children offset. Set the checkbox size to 20 pixels. Set the background color to any color such as this light blue. Set this cerulean blue for its hover background color. Give it a solid border with 3 pixels border radius for all corners. Set a light blue background color for the checkbox icon and set its size to 10. Set this color as background color for the checkbox label. Now, let's add an apply button to the checkboxes as well. Just duplicate the button we created above for price range and drag it down below the checkboxes. Okay, what we're going to do for the right column is to simply put a listing grid element. Set listing to rooms archive and the column number to 2. In the advanced tab, set the CSS ID to rooms. This will connect our listing grid to the filters on the left side. And that's it! We just created the listing page that holds the listing filters and the results. Give it a try and see how the filters set on the left side will result in the items on the right hand.
Whew. All right, that's it for the second episode of creating a dynamic hotel website with JupyterX. In this video, we created an archive listing for our rooms post type as well as nice filtering options to filter room attributes. In the next crash course, we will cover the third and the last step of the process and everything else remaining, including the booking capability. In the meantime, ask me whatever questions you have below in the comments section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button for the next crash course. Bye!